So I am going to finish this video. Let me see. I did the part one. I'm just going to call that the part one. This is about the Novo mesto police station. I'm going to do it like this, you know? I did a good job. I started to revive the memories. The first time that I actually went into it and started to look into the police station. I mean, I can tell you that when it comes to Yanis Ogulin and the man that you have just seen right there, he resigned in 2023 on April. It's about a year ago. Resigned. Let me see that. Let me see. Resigned. No, he got retired. He got retired. Okay. This is the man right here, you know. What? Let me see that. Because I never read anything about these people. Oh. Well, it's like it is when it comes to Yanis Ogulin. Yanis Ogulin was really good at his job and what he was doing because he was really good at what he was doing because he had a special quality of line. This was the most murderous individual involved in my case, this guy. There was nobody more dangerous than this guy because of what I stated, he has exceptional quality of line. And so what I stated right now, it takes me to the time when this police station was built. And this was sometimes, I think it was like, they worked on it, they built and so on, when I was in a grammar school. And they worked and they worked and they worked, but the stuff already started to happen at this new police station before they would even complete the police station. The main police station that played role in my life is the one you would not even give credit for. This is a police station. Oh, hold on, I got here ready this stuff. Yeah. This is a police station nobody even knows about these days anymore. This was the most murderous, brutal police station there was that I would know for. This was a hell. This was not a police station, you know. Back in the day, I used to live in the Novo Mesto city, just about here, right above the bank where the bank is. And then it's where I would be brought for torture. One of the locations I will be brought for torture is this police station here that you don't even see. It's right next to library. It became a library of Novo Mesto. I'll just put it this way, you know. The amount and degree of crime Serbs exercised at this police station, this was just one of the facilities, but the degree and amount of it is impossible to describe. The director who went from this police station to the other police station, these are all the people that engaged in most severe possible physical torture. This will be a type of torture that you would completely lose your sanity. You no longer would even recognize yourself in a mirror. I definitely did not recognize myself in a mirror for some 48 years. I would not recognize myself. I would not recognize myself in the videos when the police officer played them. I would not recognize myself in the mirrors. This is how fucked up this stuff was. This was a total lunacy, impossible to describe. And that's what they wanted to kill me. Finally, it was this police station that I demonstrated you earlier that opened up with the director. The old director from this place here was involved in my case probably since I was born. And it was a much better director than the two previous ones. So I could actually tell you about the police director who was police director at this police station and headed to the new police station about how that stuff went. That was when I was sometimes started to prepare for that when I was like in a seventh grade of the grammar school. So I was born in 1971. December, almost in 1972. So when I consider this, like 13 years plus, nineteen eighty-five, I can tell you all about how they selected these directors. I can tell you about the previous directors. I don't think anybody can do this stuff like this. What the fuck I knew about all these people, different people, directors, when I was a child? How the fuck would that be? It was the seventh grade of the grammar school when it was decided about who the director is going to be at the new Novo mesto police station. With people like Peter Lerler, Boucher. Don't fucking tell me these people are not Udba people. With people like, there was a circle of people. Kuchan, this was a head. This was the number one. This was the thing. The boss. Man, what a big boss this was. This was a really big boss. The biggest boss. This was the boss that wanted to get me killed. I didn't even tell you 1% of what went on. I told you a lot, right? I don't know, probably 2,000 videos over easily over 1 hour. Probably 2,000 videos, at least I have made it. And it's probably more than that, but I didn't tell you 1% about what went on. This is what they made out of it, and they always succeeded. They always got away with it, So it was like year 1986, and the car flew with me inside of one direction Belgrade Novo Mesto. 1986. Let me think about that stuff. No, actually, that was 1980, 1988, 1989. And 1989, this was Yugoslavia. There was no Slovenia anywhere in the side. And the car stopped right here at this location here, where the new police station was. And but the order came out to get me killed. Plain and simple. At this police station, at the old police station was hell, but at the new police station, the designated area for killing, not for the torture. I would not refer to this as a torture. Fuck this. This was not torture. This went way past torture. This exceeded every level of torture. There is nothing that partisans described about torture. What they described in the books was short, but this was a living hell. You know what this was here? This was a torture cells here, chambers here, this here that you see. These were literally were a torture chambers, this here. This. Right here. These were killing fields of Belgrade right here. In these cells, they murdered people. and I just happened to be one of them. And even that still, well, I was a teenager, not a child. I would not go in a group of children. Some people maybe, whatever. I was the deadliest teenager or became a teenager that entire police station feared. Because no matter what they were doing with me, they could not destroy me. They could simply not mentally destroy me to the degree that it would be it. This is how I spent weekends, weekdays, days, whatever. This is how the time flew. These prison cells were offices. These were the two interrogation locations here, right here in the background. That's why they moved them front. That's why they moved them up front, you know. They moved them when they do the hearing with the people, when people come to complain about it, they moved them here. Now, the reality was, the girl tried to fuck with me in 2013, convincing me that this was for the rookies area here, and all kinds of stories, lies they came up with. The truth is that this year, these were torture chambers. People would not get a life from here. They killed here people, Bosnian people too, and Croats. They killed them inside. Once they get you inside in here, you are better off on a graveyard. I'm just saying, I mean, this is the way it is. But you know how they did this stuff? This is the area where the so-called investigators worked. Because I know that were people that were not uniformed. You're talking about the people that were with the civil clothing. And they also had uniformed people who had only office. This was like a higher personnel. On the other side of the hallway right here, the Ogulin had his office. They could not kill me, even that the limousine that stopped right here in 1988 issued an order to get me killed. Milan Kuchan was in that limousine. And really, just as I thought that I saved my life somehow from this hellhole that I demonstrated you earlier, which is in the center of the city. What went on inside of that hellhole, I demonstrated you. But that hellhole that was inside in the center of the city, they even had a prison inside. Serbs would lock me, literally. They would go inside basically to kill, with idea to get you killed, basically. This is exactly what... this is the type of environment they got me into. This was a very dangerous environment, because if you came anywhere close to me, if you came anywhere close to the person that was on the list to get killed, you could get easily killed too. Definitely the people that from Belgrade, they would get your name on a table. And once they would get your name on a table, they would start to investigate your life, basically. Everything you do in your life, your wife, your children. Absolutely everything. See this? This? Oh boy. This is not possible to describe this hell, this shithole hellhole inside what went on here. I think I did a good job with this stuff. And so, you know, beatings included. You get the beatings from adults. And I remember some Serbs that would come. I don't even know if they worked there. There was some Serb that was there. With Slovenian people, we're not any better off. Slovenian people, when it comes to Slovenian people, do you know how they worked? And do you know how they still work? The police officers? And it doesn't matter what part you're located as a police officer. When you do a killing of the individual, execution of the individual, through use of MK Ultra, you always get approval from the victim, even for your promotion. Even that he knows that parallel to that stuff, as you tell him, is the stuff that you have to do because you're under the political pressure and so on, you do bad stuff to him. And it wasn't different from Yanis Ogulin. It was everything about, we will help you. This was the attitude. Yanis Ogulin in 1988, when I consider 1988 Yanis Ogulin, this is just about probably, I have no idea. I'm thinking, I'm trying to place him how tall he was already career-wise, you know. Where was he ranking? What exactly went on? It's also possible that he went on to study in Ljubljana, but I'm not sure. I know that they would leave to Ljubljana and then they would return. Well, I am going to go as I go along. I'm going to give you more background on Yanis Ogulin, where Yanis Ogulin was, what the fuck went on. This was a young man. In 1988, this was a really young man. One of those youngest, yet it looked like very, very promising people, police officers, who appeared to have a bright career future ahead of him. He was absolutely trying to do everything he possibly could to accommodate a police director who was transferred from the city, from the center of the city, to this new police station. But this is a very, very certain technology, certain procedure you have to go through to do this, you know. First of all, you cannot kill anybody under MK Ultra if you depict yourself as an enemy to one. There is no fucking way, because as soon as he's going to see you, he's going to go ballistic and he's going to go against you. It's those mixed feelings of friendship, even the affiliation, psychological affiliation they create through the world of lies, schizophrenia, all kinds of lies I describe on the blog, how special you are, how this, how that. They always find something that you see in a person, and then what they do is they blow that quality out of the proportions, and they use that actually to get you killed. This is the process that is not like direct execution, but it's a process of going right in your computer, that's left, left, right, left, right, left, till the individual just is dead. Simple. Thrown in a home for mentally disabled people, psychiatric hospitals, they don't even make it. As they told me when I was, I don't know, 13 years old, I'm not going to even make it to home for elderly people. They told me you could be lucky. You could consider yourself lucky if you would make it to the home for elderly people. Is this like a good description about what the fuck went on? Those with MK Ultra, no. That this is the way it is. Now, the way police officers from Novo Mesto have used the type of technology they have used to lie was a really, really special kind. This was, you can see some ambulance vehicles. The type of technology they used was, first is bread. What that means for, yeah, they said first is job, and they demanded from me to acknowledge that they cannot help me out unless there is job. And so I had to approve their promotions, literally, because this was not about the bread. This was about money. By literally allowing them not allowing them only to torture, but act stupid, awkward during the torture, like in between. In case of Yana Sogulin, it was all about the promotion. How to get the promotion, to get the promotion. And as they tortured, he explained to me, right? He explained to me, this was the most murderous individual involved in MKUltra. There was nobody more murderous than Yana Sogulin. This was the king of the rats, basically. Because of what I'm about to tell you next. For the promotions, he wanted to be a director of Novo Mesto Police. He demanded to be director of Novo Mesto Police. He was obsessed with the idea, assistant and director of Novo Mesto Police. He insisted me there are a few others they have. And he said, fuck this. When it came to few others they have, they start doing bad stuff to me. Because he gave this ticket out to a few other people who repeated one after me, after him. The type of manipulation. This is like only for the top people. It appears to me they were entitled to this type of line. To video record himself, to get approval from the victim, literally. How he agrees being them being promoted. So he used a technology that suggested that his job is number one. In other words, that I have to pray for him to get the job. Because if he's not going to get the job, he's going to be somebody else. And because he liked me, because he sided with me, because he was empathetic, he was sympathetic to me with what went on against me. I had to approve one. I had to agree with him that he should do whatever he should do so that he could get this job. In other words, I agreed to the torture to this criminal. That's how he got a green light to become, I don't know, I think assistant of police director, probably. That's how he got into this, not even assistant, but I'm going to give you the whole background, the whole what went on with the Yana Sogulin, you know, about the stuff that went on. You have to agree, no matter what, that the first thing is job, right? We are here to help you, but you have to agree that first thing is job. So not your life, not the value of your life, but you have to agree the first thing is, the first thing are our promotions at work. It doesn't matter where you are a police officer, as long as you're involved in MKUltra, you will 100% agree these are the lies you're using. From your victims. This is what you demand from your victims to recognize. This is how you do it. This is the type of stuff that goes on. So the year was probably 1989. It was about 2 years, I would say, before the Slovenian independence. 1988. The car went from Belgrade, stopped here. This building, they're going to tell you, they're going to say that there was still work going on inside in there. Fuck was not fucking work. In this area here where I was at, what the stuff went on, there was nothing about work that went on. They deliberately had work going on. And they deliberately pulled and stretched work also. There was stuff that was still doing whatever they were doing. 1988, whatever they were doing. It was a lie. The building was completed. Everything was okay, ready, but this was a Serbian headquarters here. This was a Serbian headquarters that Slovenia dedicated to Milan Kucan. To basically, this was a, Milan Kucan is bastion, this place here. And the way they operated with this place here, these offices, they would empty the offices even. There would be also offices that would empty them. Even this is the stuff they would do when they would get their victims inside, and this turned them into total fucking torture cells inside. You don't fucking see anything about what goes on. You see this here, that this is rolled down like this. This was the type of element that I would encounter inside. It was dark. You couldn't fucking see anything inside. And the torture went inside. Just here. This was the worst place here. This is where they killed people when the Novo Mesto police station opened. This new one. The new police station. This here. I will not forget Milan Kucan when he gave the order. I absolutely rejected Milan Kucan. He issued the order to get me killed at the new police station already. And it was this young man at the time with this exceptional ability to lie, with ability like nobody else had, who knew, however, that I know his filthy secret. At that time, actually, this guy was just one of like helpers, something in that sense. He wasn't even that high. He was just one of the police officers. He was some kind of a, I would even say that he was like patrulla boss, something like this, like a patrol boss or something like that, like patrolling boss or something like that, like a supervisor, something like that, right? In that sense. But he was very, very hungry, thirsty to get ahead. And it was all in the name of helping me out. Because he wanted to help me out. He was so determined he's going to help me out no matter what. It's unbelievable. This quality of line also came him right when Americans were here, where British were here, where Germans were here, where other people from abroad were here. And inside of this house, he in front of me, he lied about the filthy secret that the two of us knew, but nobody around could even possibly suspect. Nobody knew other than police about what the fuck went on. This is the secret that I'm about to reveal to you today, that this pervert sometimes, whenever he would get me in a way under his own terms, would remind me of this promise that he gave Milan Kucan. And about the stuff that went on inside of the police station about which nobody fucking knew anything about. It's a strange detail that nobody involved in MKUltra knew about this stuff. About this torture chambers that were located on the first floor in the rear. Torture chambers, which as a result had changing this area here. Probably by even construction, changing the doing a new construction, engaging in a new construction, changing the walls of the offices and so on. I do believe they have done here in this area because they were afraid that I would walk inside and eventually recognize them. Now, the truth is, I never did go here to this area. But what I gave you right now is just as much as I possibly could give you information about the beginnings of this police station, what this police station was. When it comes to the torture at the poli at this police station, they also did torture in other areas of the police station. And they, as I stated, what is very, very important, remember what I stated to you The building was already completed for 3 years when they continued to do with the work, at least 3 years, when they still continued with the work to give impression to the public that the building is still under the construction and stuff and things like this. When inside, they were already doing the stuff. So this is very, very important when it applies to this building here, extremely important detail. This is the way they operate it. Jan Zogel indeed have one office here. I don't know if this was his permanent office. That I do not know. It was one office that was across the hallway that he would be using, this office. The whole thing, he gave me impression that this year, this were investigators located here. You're talking about the older personnel. Not the younger personnel. The younger personnel, basically everything I have stated about this building is exactly what is described here in this video number one. In fact, I'm going to write down here this part number one so that you understand. One of two. And part two is going to be this one here. Everything I stated in the video about this 100% is legitimate. I don't know if this thing here, I do not know when it comes to his giving me impression about that he had his office here, that this was his office. You know, probably this was not his main office. Where his main office was, I don't know. He was here, he had office here, it appears that this was his main office, and then he changed the office. It appears as if he would move himself up toward the top of the building. He had here his office, then he had the office, somehow I had a feeling that he fits somewhere in this area here, atop in one of those rooms that was something like this. I don't know. On this side, finally, they moved him, according to my feeling about what went on, because that's about the only thing I can rely on. Probably in this area here at the top, something like this, and from there he had it toward what I believe was this area here. He is director of his office. Director's office has got to be right here at the end of it. This has got to be director's office, and this is the assistant from director here. Did you see the next thing was always the assistant of director was here. Yeah. So he probably moved here, and then from here he probably moved into this area here as a director of the police. He is exceptional ability to lie and short even much bigger importance ensured basically it ensured the Milan Kucan to survival of Milan Kucan. He had extraordinary ability to lie, to present himself in a role of the victim to the victim while representing this individual, continuing to represent, basically chop the systematically head off while representing this individual in absolutely every sense possible. So it happened that in 2009, Milan Kucan gave him a green light to propel himself as a director of the police station. So this was like in this time they did absolutely everything possible to get me into psychiatric hospital.
I told you they worked on that procedure at least 4 years. It was the crazy stuff that went on throughout the United States of America, Chicago, all over the place, Britain, all over the Europe, everywhere. It was violence was just incredible. Explosion of the violence, explosion. And it showed up in my real life, on me gaining weight, it was, as he stated, me to get me killed in the face. But this was the man whom he represented, this guy here. And he did not represent one in 2009. He didn't start to represent him in 2009. When the car stopped in 1988 in front of this intersection. This is what I think they even claimed the building was completed, something like this. But I told you this building was completed already before, way before. I think they claimed that the building was completed like in 19, I don't know. I really didn't pay attention to, even though I lived in the city, I didn't go through here and pay attention to what the fuck went on. This is another side of the city. I was from the other side of the city, actually from the other sides of the city, from the other side of the city, and then we moved to the village, basically, this place here, Kirka, which is like 4 kilometers away from the city. Not that we would not go past here, we would oftentimes. But in 1988, the car that stopped here, director started to look what the fuck to do with me. Because police director had a problem. And you know when I told you earlier that in MKUltra procedure that you have to go left and right and left and right and left and right till you hit the victim and basically, you know, confuse one through confusion, basically destroy his life, get him killed. They lost a lot of trust. I was quite brilliant. And despite whatever the fuck they were doing with me, they could only go to the certain degree as to would become everything too evident about what went on. He simply searched for an individual that had this exceptional line, abilities to pretend himself like he is, you know how beautiful the fuck that is. You know, you torture somebody, you do the stuff occasionally you do to him. You always, when it's the torture, when it's a total madness, it was a technology that was used always to make me search for somebody that was not as bestial as others, but who still in the face would go and betray me. This was the technology that's used. Actually, it's a technology that's always used during MKUltra. You have eight beasts, and you get one that supposedly is your friend, but is displaying like fear to be your friend. And then you have other two that already betrayed you. You know what I mean? That kind of stuff. And then that is supposedly pretending that is your friend, but is afraid to be a friend, also have to do something bad to you. Oh, this is basically what we are talking about here. This is the type of technology we are talking about. That's like well described Yanis Ogulin technology he alone used. I mean, this is universal, but this was a technology that he alone used to get promotion. Anybody could get promotion. You are willing to kill somebody. This is not a police. This is not in a sense of protecting people's rights, protecting people's freedoms, protecting, giving people safety. Do you understand me? What the fuck I am saying to you right now? This is not the police. This is not a police station. It's not a police. Like, hello, it's Bob here. All right, it's police dispatcher. Please give me your name, address, whatever. What do you need? What can we do for you? What happened, sir? I have somebody I don't know, robbing my house, or I have a robbery in the process, or I need help, my God, they are gonna do something and so on and so forth. This is not what this shit is. This is just partially this. Most of the crime that happens in Slovenia, I attribute literally to Slovenian police. This here, this stuff here, everything that I talk to you about is a crime. Everything is a fucking crime, including this here. Including this thing here. This is a fucking crime. Serious one. Where it says FUK in the background right there. That's a serious crime. Everything is a crime. Every fucking graffiti that is in the city, every fucking graffiti was approved by the police. And they were all designed to demoralize, basically to scorn the public, to downplay, to brain kill people's expectations, the right to freedom. Not the right to freedom, but the right to their nationality, the right to their country. This is a totally lossless banana republic, not Auschwitz on open. This is a Chetnik state here, in a process completely, as much as one possibly can be. They do solve problems to the people. There is somebody out there that stabs another one or punches, they have a disagreement, whatever, over I don't know what. Pity stuff. Whatever the fuck people have too much time at hand. There is all kinds of stuff like this that go on. It's all kinds of issues, and that's why they have those cars that ride around and so on, but there is much, 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 much more that's being done in here. This is where the political executions go through, right here. This is where professional burglars design through the burglary and killings processes at the courts, right through this building here. This is where it all goes through, right through here. This is a major promoter of the crime, of the organized crime, what people refer to the gang stalking and stuff like that. This goes way beyond. This is childish. Gang stalking kind of is like teasing. And in my eyes, for me, the expression of gang stalking is actually insultive because it downplays the meaning of the building as you see right there. You understand me what the fuck I'm saying? You could say this is the building, this type of buildings. With this type of buildings basically enforce your constitution. That's for what your tomorrow is going to be. They basically, through this, through the buildings like this, the society is designed. I don't want to go into the details. You already know. You see the news, you see the media, what it looks like. It depends on your country, whatever. This building did not serve anybody else than Milan Kucan. This building never served anybody else than Milan Kucan. That I'm going to tell you. And this individual had exceptional ability. He resigned unfucking believable in 2023. I can hardly fucking believe that he resigned in 2000, actually, that retired in 2023. I don't know, was it due to years? I have no idea. Did he did so many years already that he retired, or what the fuck went on? I do not know. He was bagging the police director. You're talking about 1991. You see, when I said 91, this was a transition 91, Yugoslavia no longer existed. In 1991, Yugoslavia smashed down, crashed. And his talents of presenting himself as a friend, as an ally, as a major supporter, now surfaced totally and were more desired. The chameleon character were now more desired and willing to kill, basically more desired than ever. Because it was about the life of this individual here. Now all of a sudden these people have found themselves in a new country. Yugoslavia was gone of the picture, the new country popped up, the name of the country was Slovenia. And they Slovenian people never tolerated this individual. No Slovenian house, it was Slovenian house, would open this man a door any fucking where at any fucking time. He became a president of Yugoslavia, of New Slovenia, because those that were ensuring elections, those that were enforcing elections, knew exactly how to do this throughout Slovenia. This was not only here through the Novo mesto, it was everywhere like this. You remember when I told you about police job? Police job is all about the money. Police job is all about the money. It doesn't matter what country you are. It doesn't fucking matter what country you are. Remember what I told you? I cannot help you if somebody else is going to get the job. When they mention a new opportunity that opens, they throw away absolutely everything that is out there and they run to that to pick up the money, to pick up cash. And what's in it for you? Well, sometimes in the future, I suppose, the person who landed that job is going to help you. And you better approve one, because if you're not going to approve one, he's not going to get the job, so he won't be capable to help you. This is the brainwash. This is the system. This is how that stuff is done. This is how the stuff was done in my case. It was done on a few occasions with only the highest personnel at the police using it for their promotions. Little did I get help from these people ever. I didn't get any kind of help. This criminal inside of our house in front of the British have accused me of deliberately boycotting Novo Mesto police station, that he accused me of hating them. He did this in front of the British, Americans, Germans, and have done everything possible to associate himself mentally during the visits of the British royals, Americans, Scandinavians, Germans, and everybody to depict himself as a victim of mine. Not only him, but both of them started to depict them, so they were all using the same technology, how much I hate them. Well, you would fucking hate them too if they were beating the fuck out of you at a police station and torture you and brain electroshock you and do this stuff. You wouldn't like them either. That I guarantee you. You wouldn't like them either. You can say all you want, but you wouldn't like them either. And so they had this special quality of playing victims, that there is some kind of hatred in me, and that I hate them, and that this hatred for them is unlimited. But it took absolutely no responsibility for the truth, for the facts. And never before have anybody played a role as important as this shit here that you see right there. Nobody ever played as important a role because he became my victim too. He was such a nice guy who wanted me to do the video about the Novo Mesto police station. He claimed that in MKUltra, as soon as you do this video, it's over. You're free. But he knew the dirty secret about it. He knew the filthy stuff, and he continued to ignite that feeling during MKUltra that I don't like them, and why I don't like them, and insisted that I should do the video, and how good is it going to be for all of them, that they're going to get also money, that they're going to be entitled to reward with me together, and we're all going to be wealthy and rich and so on. This was his poetry. This was his poisoning. This is how he poisoned. This was the logic behind it all. A beautiful, innocent smile, playing straight in the face of the people, looking at the people straight in the eyes, and laugh about the little secret, as he referred to as a little secret between him and me. Eventually, he managed to create the victim out of this guy in the eyes of foreign people who liked that stuff because Angela Merkel also wanted to be victim. She is laughing with these teeth here that you see here, Angela Merkel. They also, they changed the picture, but it was this smile, this big smile with a teeth that were displayed that she already had on her profile. That's fucking gone. Look, maybe it's because of the videos about my teeth now that I posted. A German Regierung, Deutsche government, this is always the picture, her picture, the profile. Because she suggested me that she will get my teeth destroyed. She was into it. These people had a lot of problems with me because the more shit, the more crime, the more genocide they did against me, the more they fell in a role of this individual here that you see. This Milan Kucan. And it went like this with absolutely everybody, including British royals and all American presidents. All of a sudden, they all fucking see themselves as victims. They became fucking victims. Everybody became victims. Everybody was my victim. See this? This man here? So don't say that I did not identify Novo Mesto police station or by any chance that I don't identify Janusz Ogulin. He would drive me to Croatia and so on. What is this, some place, Ogulin, some castle, whatever they have, and pose over there in front of me, and do all kinds of circus they would do, and how they're gonna help me, and and what I can tell you, it was fantastic inside of the psychiatric hospital, and it was worse stuff. I don't even know what to tell you about my life when I consider. He had exceptional quality to lie, to look person in the face, to look like a normal human being. A victim. You see? Normal human being, a victim. These are the qualities of the politician. While strangling somebody, yes? During the murder procedure, in the middle of the murder, basically. These are the requirements for you to become a politician today. This is what is expected of you. That's why no human being in this world should ever, when they see in front of them, wherever they see, assume that an individual and that nobody's more rotten than politicians is anywhere even normal individual that is in front of one. The politicians are everything but normal. They have other issues on their mind. He really wanted to help me. He just didn't know what the fuck to do. He was thinking about actually with his assistant. Investigators, even to sit in the car and come here to me at my home and talk to me about is what he claimed. in 2017. But wait a minute, this was in 2017. But in 2010, when I started to talk about MKUltra, he was busy to get me killed for ASAP, which he really caused tremendous damage in 2012 by accusing me with the courts, with the police, all kinds of lies stuff. I had nothing to do with it. These are the qualities, the real qualities, not only of the politicians, but also of the police officers. Remember, Yanis Ogulin, at one point in time in his life, also was a police officer. And in the police officer's world, they cannot help you if they don't land that job. It's all about that job. It's about the position. It's about that job. Because he ain't gonna take one. He ain't gonna be able to help you. And just remember, you need to acknowledge this. This here was the investigation department, this here. Originally, the investigation department was located here. This was the originally. And then they went on and they even changed walls here. They even rearranged rooms. There was all kinds of shit they did. So that the truth about this place here would not be known, would not be recognizable. Even this is the kind of stuff that went on. During the torture, the chairs, the tables, all kinds of stuff would go out when they would do. They turned this into the torture cells. These were interrogation rooms, basically, this here. This. No? For Yanis Ogulin, these people here, this here were very, very important. I think this is what it all started for him, here in this area here that you see. This here, these people here. There's some older police officers before he moved up there. This is what it all started for him. This was a uniformed police officer. Vodia Patrole, I have no idea what the fuck he was. How it all started. And he was moving up with a lightning speed. And according to his words, when he will be authorized, is what he threatened me during MKUltra. For the last 30 years, he will sit into the chair of the police director. And the whole thing, these are his words I am repeating to you because this is what he was traumatizing me with, will depend on this man here when he will put his finger up or down, whatever it was. This is Yanis Ogulin, and this is the history about Novo Mesto Police, if you like, new Novo Mesto Police Station. So you remember this. About the Novo Mesto police station, what the Novo Mesto police station was. This here, this place here, this place did not, this place, what I hoped is going to be, when they told me that they have this for the new police station in like a seventh grade, for the new police station they're going to do the transfer. And they're going to go to the new police station. This here, I was so looking forward to because they told me it's going to be a new police station. And that was a good looking police station. It looks like one of those modern buildings, It looked like a modern building. This here, this was fucking hell, man, this place here. This was a hellhole, this place. I was so happy that this shit is going to come to an end. This place. And what turned out to be a reality at the new police station at this place here. Because those that enforced this crime against me were police investigators, or they were older people. When I found myself at this motherfucker place here, this, with all the police investigators even laughing in my face, and the director that liked me so much, and because of what he was promoted, because this is how they do it, they kill the will for life. They create hope just to kill one with ultra violence. What they refer to as MK Ultra, that's ultra violence. That's what this shit is all about. I wasn't excited about this new place very soon afterwards. Everything, all the command, everything came from Belgrade, Serbia. I told you already the plans they have for me. What is here to say?